brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offering gifts the sacrificial gifts we offer for the soul of your servant, Bishop Martin, that as you accorded him the pontifical dignity in this world, so may you command him to be admitted to the company of your saints in the heavenly kingdom, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone, he accepted death so that we might all escape from dying. As one man, he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in the company of the choirs of angels, we praise you as with joy we proclaim. are indeed holy. O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Venias.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, faith, and hope, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the bishops and all the clergy.
Remember your servant and bishop, Martin Luruga, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father,
in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command and formed by his teaching, let us say the prayer he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Amen.
Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter.
Within the Catholic faith who are well disposed to receive the body of Christ, we shall request that you wait to communicate from the priest who will come closest to you, so that we avoid the burden of moving up and down. New Megu, Queen Megu Mwa, Magitia, Ish, me, Ecclesia Catholica, ma, you bear my bell, me, no, compa, Christo, I be quiet near. I bear the camera in the Asia, Cadon, Ishima, Kumunia, I bang, Padre, Kunimia, Kedikon, Mubino, Kago, I bay, Makara. Go to Makama Boru Berupe. Now, the Pima Gupi, Mobile, I take Lisa Katuka, me, the Maria Rotupira, the CP, Rua, Christo Dire Suzuri, Anamia Ikini, Ite Parimini Azuriada, Midira Yemu, Eucharist Esu. Padre, a mopi mevo of Gogwa, and then a revo. Bane ane achizu, ezo kareku, achizu, uruandwa, duadale, duadale kubeni. Those who have umbrellas, you can kindly help us to provide shade for those who are going to distribute the body of Christ. Thank you for the quick response. I've seen some people already responding. Thank you. Can you take the umbrella? Make me a new bino. The part. The people.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We pray, Almighty and merciful God, that as you made your servant Bishop Martin an ambassador for Christ on earth, so may you raise him, purified by his sacrifice, to be seated with Christ in heaven, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever. All dear mourners, I want to appreciate your presence here on behalf of the bishops, particularly the Bishop of Nebi. Two, I have one major announcement. Some of you may have heard already. This year, on the 20th of November, we shall have one of the human beings who was a Kombone missionary being raised to the level of blessed at Kalongo in Gulu Archdiocese. Those who can make it, it will be also most welcome. I'm sure he will be grateful to you. And those who can also give some hands to support the preparation, most welcome too. So I will be giving now the final blessing to conclude this mass, after which other items will follow. I would invite all my brother bishops, we come here together and impart God's blessing upon his people. The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Be seated. Dear mourners, we want to thank you very much for praying together in this sacrifice of Mass. And most especially, we thank His Grace, the Archbishop John Baptist Odama, for leading us through this Mass. Thank you very much. From after here, we shall have the Bishop Ordinary of Nebi Catholic Diocese, who will invite the Bishop Chairman of the Episcopal Conference to say a word. And after that, we shall go for the final commentation and the laying on of the wreaths. After the laying on of the wreaths, we shall have the procession to the burial ground. And after the burial, we shall come back here to have the speeches. But because the burial ground and the space is so little, we shall only ask some few representatives to go to witness the burial. Meanwhile, the rest of us will keep praying from here as we wait for the burial to be done and have the speeches and the reception thereafter. So in the interest of time, with the humility, may I therefore invite the Bishop Ordinary, Bishop Raphael Okoraj Pumoin, to come and invite to say a word, and thereafter invite the Bishop Chairman of the Episcopal Conference also to make some remarks. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. First of all, I want to reiterate the thanks also to the presiding bishop of this mass, His Grace John Baptist Odama. We thank you very much. A moment like this may appear as a moment of sadness, but as it was already indicated, I believe the grace has touched us and turned things to make it be a moment of joy and grace. Death occurs, and in this death, we find that we have met many friends that we never met for a long time. And this is where I see the great grace of God in our midst. Most of the priests I met a long time ago, I've just met them, I don't know, maybe 20, 30 years ago. It is today that I met. Probably some of you have the same similar experience. Maybe also the others. Well, now I would like simply to pass a word of thanks before I invite the chair of the conference, Episcopal Conference, His Lordship, the Reverend Anthony Ziwa, Chairman, Uganda Episcopal Conference, and the Bishop Ordinary of Mitiana Catholic Diocese, and also all the bishops present here. We welcome you. I should have done this at the beginning of the Mass, but because of time that was pressing, we went straight to here. The history of the bishop who has passed on. And so I welcome you as chair representing all the bishops in Uganda, Catholic bishops in Uganda. In this time, I want to pass special appreciation to His Holiness the Pope for his special message of condolence, heartfelt gratitude also to the nuncio, apostolic nuncio, for the words of encouragement to us in this hard time. Special tribute to all of you present here as bishops. Your Grace, John Baptist Odama, we thank you dearly, for from the very time you heard of the death of Bishop Martin, you filled the great gap that my absence from the diocese had created, and to give all the fatherly and fraternal advice required, and personally came to see things move in the right direction. I thank your office too for the great assistance that we received. I am thankful to Bishop Sabino Odoki and Arua Diocese as a whole, who helped our diocesan office a great deal from the moment the news about the demise of the Bishop Emeritus was passed out. Thanks for your brotherly concern and personally coming to direct our office on ground. May God bless you on your trip. Thanks to Bishop Sanctus for the brotherly concern and coordination in this same matter. I thank in particular the medical workers from Ulago, Nebi, and Angal, who labored so much within their limits for the life of our father, the Bishop Emeritus. And in a particular way, I want to make mention of Dr. Amandua Jacinto, as also the Vicar General presented to us. To thank also nurses Sylvia Nyayo and Jane Francis Mundoro. We want to thank in a particular way Father Losio Suriem. I remember the last day I met Bishop Martin in Kampala. We had breakfast together, and Father Losius was there, and he had gone for the ordinary, regular medical checkups. At that breakfast, Bishop said, "This breakfast I've taken is enough. The rest I will take at 10:30, then lunch." This was the last word I had with him face to face. We thank Father Losius for accompanying all these years. We thank David, his driver, and some people, including Megu Catherine Mavengina. I think Mavengina, Honorable Mavengina, had a personal attention to Bishop Martin all this time. And also, when Mavengina was elected as the representative of the elderly in the parliament, Bishop made a mention, "Now I am in the right place with you." From 2015, Bishop has been journeying with pain, and all those who in one way or another assisted Bishop, he never forgot to make mention of them, more especially when I paid him visit. And he will want always to recall and thank them in a particular way. Apart from being the second Bishop of Nebi Catholic Diocese, Bishop Emeritus has been a father to me and to many in this diocese. And beyond a grandfather who tirelessly gave his life for his diocese, I personally owe Bishop Emeritus Martin a special consideration. He sent me to the minor seminary for care, and he also ordained me priest. Looking at the priest present here, it made me recall that Bishop Martin touched lives of many. In a locum, he was our teacher, and for many, I believe he was their spiritual director. Today, we accompany him and honor the good work he did all his time as a minister of the church. His works are a testimony of his life. They say almost all what is simple and keen in his, is very attentive in every little detail of his work. He will rarely speak a lot about himself. But when you see the work he did, there were many that speak a lot about him. And I think that is the irony for which we think he is a great man. Man of keen attention. He can read one's mind simply. As it was said, he loved nature. Trees around this residence in front of us is Bishop Martin's work. We thank you, Bishop Martin Luluga, for going ahead of us in promoting green evangelization. Appreciation also goes to the COC members, the parishes, and all those who have labored to make our beloved bishop accorded a decent send-off. May God bless you all. When we consider the life of those who faithfully followed Christ, we are inspired with a new reason to seek the new city, the heavenly Jerusalem, where millions of the saints and the angels of Christ await us with joy. We are most safely taught the path by which, amidst the changing and passing things of this world, we remain steadfast and firm on our lane of race to the finish. Amid this unbearable pain, our father, our grandfather Martin, the Bishop Emeritus, leaves this as a message for all of us. His time has come. So may we go in peace and in turn pray for us always. Amen. Bishop Martin Luluga was a friend of the Franciscans. He invited the Franciscan brothers to this diocese and has started a special program to promote the spirituality of environment and farming. I think this is a remarkable gift to the diocese. This morning too, I met some Franciscan nuns who presented themselves as special friends of Bishop Martin Luluga. They came all the way from Jinja and Tororo just to pay this tribute. And because of them, I thought it is important that they stand in front of just people to see, and they wave to them. They wanted to come and sing. They wanted even to present some gifts, but I told them we don't have time, we can do that another day. Maybe where they are, they can stand and wave to the people. Lastly, today, August 17th, is the day when Bishop Martin Luluga, two of our priests, one is the Vicar General, Monsignor Osiga Jackson, and Father Hercules. Bishop Martin Luluga ordained them on this day, and today they are celebrating 20 years of ordination. Congratulations. And I wish you all a joyful moment together, and I wish you journey mercies and God's blessings. And before we go, I would like simply to introduce to you the bishops present who have concelebrated with us. I start with Bishop Anthony Ziwa. He's the Bishop Chairman of the Uganda Episcopal Conference and Bishop of the Catholic Diocese of Mitiana, Kihinda Mitiana. I introduce to you Bishop Joseph Echiro. Bishop Joseph is Bishop of Soroti. I introduce to you Bishop Damiano Giuseppe, is the Bishop of Moroto. I introduce to you Bishop Severius Njumba, who is the Bishop of Masaka. I introduce to you Bishop Sosten Ayekulo Ajua. He is the Bishop of Mahagi Diocese. I introduce to you Bishop Santos Linus Wanok. The Bishop of Lira Diocese. Finally, I introduce to you His Grace John Baptist Odama, whom you all know. The first Bishop of Nebi Catholic Diocese. And now he's the Bishop of the Archdiocese of Gulu. I want to introduce to you Monsignor John Baptist Kauta, the Secretary General of the Episcopal Conference. I want to introduce to you the representative of the Archbishop of Kampala, Monsignor Kalumba. Who was my teacher also. He used to be a very good footballer. I believe he's still. And I want to introduce to you Vicar General, Castor Adeti, the Vicar General of Arua. Monsignor Matthew Odongo, Vicar General of Gulu. I introduce to you Monsignor Emmanuel Wachgiu, Vicar General of Mahagi Diocese. We have Bishop Emeritus of the Church of Uganda, His Grace Luke Orombi. We have the Bishop Ponce Ozele of Church of Uganda, maybe Diocese. And with this, now I take the opportunity to invite Bishop Ziwa, Anthony Ziwa, the chair of the Episcopal Conference Uganda, to come and address us. Welcome, Bishop.
Thank you very much, Your Lordship, Raphael Wokorach, Bishop of Nebi Catholic Diocese. As introduced, I stand here on behalf of the Uganda Episcopal Conference, the Catholic bishops in Uganda. Allow me not to go through all the protocol and simply say, my dear brothers and sisters, my fellow mourners. We convey our condolences to you, as they have already been given in that small booklet. First of all, to Bishop Wokorach, the bishop of this diocese, the archbishop and the bishops of Gulu Ecclesiastical Province, the clergy, religious, the laity, and all people of God for the big loss of the demise of Bishop Luluga. I received this news when I was away from the country. I was in Ghana attending the meeting for the bishops from Catholic bishops from Africa, known as SECAM, Symposium of Episcopal Conferences of Africa and Madagascar. I represented Uganda. So I conveyed our message of the death of Bishop Luluga, and I can say that the bishops, Catholic bishops in Africa, conveyed their condolences to us on the death of Bishop Luluga. I have also received condolence message from the chairman of AMISEA, that is the Association of Member Episcopal Conferences of Eastern Africa. These are conferences from eight countries from Eastern Africa. They convey condolences to us on the death of our beloved bishop. I would like to thank you, Bishop Wokorach, for your patience and letting us to participate in this Mass from the very start. We are sorry for the late arrival, but as you know, not all of us can control the skies. We are supposed to leave at 8. However, we could not leave before we are cleared. And I think we are cleared at around 8:40 in the morning. We are supposed to spend about 1 hour and 20 minutes. I think we spent about 1 hour and 40 minutes. So that's why we arrived late. Thank you, Bishop Wokorach and the team, for your patience in allowing us to participate from the very start of this celebration. I'm here to about my name. It's not easy to pronounce. And then you add on a Joseph, which is also problematic to some people. So he said that some people would call me Jiwa. Now, I take you back to the meetings. So when I saw him during the meetings, you have had a good point, but he has said nothing. And I wanted his silence to speak. So during break time, because I had told him that, okay, you call me Jiwa, I will also call you Jiwa. Not Iruruga, but I call you Jiwa. So during that time, I would talk to him quietly. I would call him and say, hey, Bishop Jiwa from Nebi, I want to see you. And he would go on the side and speak. And then that was a moment for me to seek wisdom from him. Those points which we had discussed, and yet he had remained quiet. And he would speak to me. For that, Bishop Luga, I'd like to thank you. He was quiet, but sober in his thought, and he would give us advice on many things. When he was approached, he would be very open and constructive in his quality discussion. We thank him for that. We'd like to thank him for his love of nature. The AMESEA meeting, which has been held in Dar es Salaam last month, was on environment. But as Bishop Okorach has said, when you move around his residence, he has really, may I say, repaired what might have gone wrong with nature. As Archbishop Odamas was apologizing to the trees around, I think Bishop Luruga did it already for us from the time he started planting trees, even when he was walking on a stick. Thank you very much, Bishop Luruga. I would like to thank all of you for having come in such big numbers. At one time I was wondering, as we are coming in for the mass, I said, are all these from Nebi Diocese? But then remembering, I could see some whom I also had taught in Gava, and they don't come from this diocese. So I knew, and it's not a fallacy, and unless they were excadinated, I knew that they were coming from those other dioceses. And so on this occasion, I've had also the opportunity to meet some of my, I may call them my former classmates, whom I taught. I call them classmates. The only difference was, while they were looking at the blackboard, I was looking at the students. But we were in the same classroom. So I thank God was giving us this opportunity to meet again. And my dear brothers, the priests, thank you for coming, for honoring the great work that Bishop Luruga did, especially in the area of formation. Brothers and sisters, thank you for coming. Thank you for giving this, I'm even call it glorious farewell to Bishop Luruga. When I look at the people around here, I've been listening to the choirs singing in different languages, and he understands those languages very well. Thank you for coming from that far and for all that you have done. We continue to pray for him. We pray for Bishop Okorach, the new bishop of Nebi, whom we would even think that Muzei would be around to advise him, but has been with him for a very short time. Thank you, Bishop, for having taken care of him. Thank you, all of you, for loving Bishop Luruga to this moment. We pray for him, and let us summarize by saying, let his silence continue to speak. Even here, your coming and what you are doing is making his silence speak. Let us retain the good things we have learned from him so that his legacy can continue to live on. May the soul of Bishop Martin Luger rest in eternal peace.
Thank you very much, Bishop Chairman of the Episcopal Conference. May I now invite the Archbishop to who will lead us through the final commentation, and then after that he will lay the first wreath, and then the other people will lay theirs according to the order that we have here. And after the laying on of the wreaths, we shall have the burial procession. And we shall have some few who will go to represent us at the burial ground. And as I said earlier, we shall request those of us who are not among those who will represent us there to remain around. It is not segregation that we are allowing few to go, but it is because the space is little. Thank you. We shall only request the bishops to go with him, with the main celebrant, where the casket is, and the servers. The rest of us can attend to the prayers from where they are. We shall have the first wreath laid by the main celebrant, Archbishop John Baptist Odama. There will be a wreath laid by the chairman, Bishop Chairman of the Episcopal Conference, then the Bishop Ordinary of Navy Catholic Diocese. We shall have a wreath laid by the government representative, who will be led by the Honorable Minister Obiga Kania and the Honorable Minister Kuching Grace. Then we shall have the wreath laid by the head of the laity. Those will be laid by Honorable Catherine Akuma Vengina and Mr. Kaba Sam. I will continue the order after the prayers. And I will ask those who will be involved in the laying on of the wreaths already to be around and closer.
With the faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother, Bishop Martin, to be buried in his human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up his mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give him a merciful judgment, and forgive all his sins. May Christ the Good Shepherd lead him safely home to be at peace with God our Father. And may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King.
People of the press, you can set your machines and leave them recording, and you allow space for those behind you to see and visually witness what is happening. Thank you.
We shall respond. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Come to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Give him eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on him forever. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Father, into your hands we commend our brother Bishop Martin. We are confident that with all you have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day. and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our brother Bishop Martin to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ to be with you and with our brother Bishop Martin forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new eternal Jerusalem. May I request, as we bishops here, to impart our blessings upon his body, as we say the prayer normally of recommending to him to eternal rest. Eternal rest give unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. Eternal rest give unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. Eternal rest give unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen.
We shall have now the laying on of the wreaths. The first will be by the main celebrant, and then followed by, let me say, the bishops, led by the bishop chairman of the Episcopal Conference. After the main celebrant, have the wreath laid by the bishop chairman together with the other bishops. Then we have the bishop ordinary of Nebi Catholic Diocese. The government representatives led by the two honorable ministers present. And then after them, we can have all the MPs present. You could come as a team. The MPs present immediately after the honorable ministers. The head of the laity, led by Honorable Catherine Akuma Vengina and Mr. Okaba Sam. These are doing it on behalf of the laity of Ganal. That is the laity from the Archdiocese of Gulu, comprising of Nebi, Arua, Gulu, and the leader. After the laity, after the honorable MPs, we have the head of the laity. Yes. Then after that, we have the representative of the priests, who will be led by the chairperson of the priests of Nebi Diocese. If we have the chairperson of the priests from the other neighboring dioceses or representatives, they could join Father Albert Oromchan, who is the chairperson of the priests from Nebi. After that, we have the representative of the religious men and women. prayers. After the representative of the religious men and the women, I'm only seeing one sister going there. If we have also some brothers. We have religious houses here. And then after that, we have the RDC of Nebi. If there are other neighboring RDCs here, they could also join. After that, we have the family representatives. After the religious there, may I have the RDC. Please, RDC, your team come closer. After the RDC, let us have the family representatives. The family representatives, you come closer. After the family representatives, we have, there are people who have special wreaths. If you have them, you could come immediately after the family representatives. And as a rule, for us within the Catholic Diocese, we emphasize that the wreaths you lay should really be the natural flowers, so that they signify our immortality. There are these artificial flowers who apparently do not decompose and wither in any way as soon as we expect. So those who have wreaths, we, for the purposes of avoiding crowding, we expect some few representation of those who have those special wreaths. The delegation from Kampala, you have been asked to go to the bishop's house. Yes, thank you. Now, from here, we shall have the procession, the burial procession to the burial ground. So as the procession is going on, as the procession is going to get organized, we have that yes, the order.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I'm alone. Jesus, Lord, lead me home. Precious Lord, take